स्क्रीन रिकॉर्डिंग एंड आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर द वीडियो टू बोथ ऑफ यू एंड वेद एज वेल सो दैट देन इट विल बी इजी फॉर यू. ओके ओके सो कीप योर आर्डुइनो आईडीई ऐप रेडी. आई एम स्टार्टिंग स्क्रीन शेयरिंग. Can everyone see the screen?
Yes.
Okay. So I am going to Arduino app. Okay, so in the first class, sorry, second class, Adrut. Hello, Adrut.
Yes.
We had learned how to introduce connections. So
yes.
Can any one of you, Adrut or Ojas, tell me how to introduce new connections?
Constant.
Wonderful, Ojas and Adrut. Wonderful. And now, whenever you are introducing a connection, first you have to write const int. Remember that thing, const int, and then the name of the pin. For example, Adrut, you give me a name, and then I will ask Ojas.
LED pin.
Okay. LED pin, and you can give or write however you want. Okay, you can write the name however you want, and then you have to tell where it is connected, like whenever you want to switch on or
13.
off. Yeah, wait just 2 minutes. Whenever you want to connect a pin somewhere on the Arduino board and you are using it as an output, you will connect it to digital pin. So you will write it as any digital pin number, as Ojas said 13. So you can write any digital pin. I will write as 3. And then in the next line, Ojas, it's your chance. Oh, just now tell me one pin name which you want to give it. Hello, Ojas.
Yes. 11.
No, sorry. Not the pin number. You have to give the name first.
LED2.
Okay, LED2. And where we are going to connect it?
11.
Okay, we can connect it wherever we want. And after that, Adrut and Ojas, like in the game programming class, void setup and void loop function. Setup function is for whenever you want your function needed to be run only once. And here, like a loop, it will be repeated again and again. So, we have told Arduino that, Arduino, I have connected the pin here, but we have not told whether it is an input or output. Okay, so like LED, it gives out light, and whenever we are using a sensor, it will be input, and LED is an output. So we'll write as pin mode LED pin output. And then I will introduce Ojas pin as well. LED2, comma, output. So now it's fine. Now in void loop function, we want to switch it on or switch it off. So this question, I'm going to ask question one by one, as today's class is actually a revision class. So Adrut, you can answer or I will ask to Ojas. How to switch on a pin?
Okay.
So you would like to answer it or Ojas?
Let him decide. Let Ojas decide.
Okay. So Ojas, would you like to switch? Tell what is the answer to my question, or Adrut will tell?
I will try.
Okay. So how to switch on a pin?
We would write digital write in in void loop.
Okay, then.
And then brackets, and then. we will write the name of the LED.
Okay, so LED pin, and then what should we write and now?
High.
And what if I write low?
Capital high.
Yes. So, in digital pens, whenever you are using digital pens, remember one thing, that whenever digital means like transmission of data in binary state, 0 and 1. Digital means the transmission of data in 0 and 1. Remember that thing. So, 0 stands for low. If you write here 0, it means that the pin will be switched off. And if you write 1, it means that the pin will be switched on. That means that high is equal to 1. And low is equal to Ojas or Ved. Ojas and or Adrut.
0.
0 is equal to what?
Low.
And
low.
High is equal to?
1.
Wonderful. So now we want to switch on. So just for a change, I will write as 1. And then, now I want my LED to be switched on for some particular time. So what should I write? This question is for Adrut.
Can you repeat?
Now I want the pin to be switched on for a particular time. Like whenever we are doing a task, a particular time will be given to us. For example, I am seeing TV. So there will be some time given to me for seeing TV. Like you can see the TV for only 1 hour. So on. So here. Adrut?
Delay.
Yes, wonderful.
Delay.
Wonderful, Adrut. And here, we'll be writing the time in milliseconds. So if 1 second, then it means 1000 milliseconds. If you write 100, it will be 0.1 second. So let's write it. Ojas or Adrut, who would like to tell how much time should we switch it on?
5000.
Just means for your simplicity, I am writing 2 Whenever you put 2 slashes in front, you can comment the code and then you can give information. Okay. Okay, so I've commented the code, and so for how much time should we switch it on? Hello?
Yes, 5000.
Okay, so 5000 means 5 seconds. So we'll switch it on for 5000 seconds. And now, I had asked Adrut. So now, Ojas, you tell me how to switch on your pen.
Write digital write.
I had asked Ojas. Adrut. Hello, Adrut.
Yes.
Can you tell how to switch off this LED pin?
Digital write LED pin.
Yes.
Bracket LED pin.
Yes.
0 or low in capital.
Wonderful, Adrut. Very good. And after this, I want that it should be switched off for 2 seconds. So how I will write that?
Delay 2000 seconds in bracket.
Wonderful. Very good. So here is our code and it will be working properly. There is no need to check it. However, if you want, I will send this code to you. Shall I send this code to you?
It will be okay.
So later on, I will be sending the code. So okay. Are the concept clear how to switch on and switch off for LED pin?
Yes.
Sure?
Yes.
So okay, let's have a small test for both of you. I'm going to ask you some questions and you will be answering. And I will tell who should answer. Okay?
Okay.
So now I'm connecting my LED. I'm connecting my LED to the Arduino Uno board. So there are two pins, as everyone knows, the positive pin and negative pin. And I have written in the code that the pin which will be switched on is connected to pin 13. So can anyone tell me where the positive and negative pin will be connected?
Yes.
Who would like to answer? Okay, wait. I will repeat the question. I have written that the pin which will be switched on or off will be pin 13. So where will be the positive pin and negative pin of Arduino connected?
Positive will be on 13 and negative on ground.
Very good, Adrut. So as Adrut answered the first question, the second question will be for Ojas. So the second question is, as we Adrut told that we will connect in such a way, there is some problem with my code. Okay, there is a slight problem with my code and it is showing that the pin is not defined. In pin mode, hello?
Yes.
In yes. pin yes. mode, it is telling that the pin which I have written, like LED1, was not defined.
Constant int and LED pin is equal to 13. You should write, no?
You are brilliant, Adrut. So, Adrut, I'm really amazed by your excellency, but please stop answering. Everyone must just get a chance. No, you are answering. That was not a bad thing. It was really wonderful. Ojas, we have introduced pins. And a friend told me to switch on a LED for 10 seconds. Okay.
Delay 10,000.
Okay. And I have introduced the pin as LED pin 1. So what I will write to switch it on?
You would write digital write.
Yes.
Digital write LED 1, comma 0 to switch it on.
Yes, I want to switch it on.
So, digital write LED 1, and then
for switching
the
on
time
1.
That you want to.
For switching, like,
yes.
I'm writing switch it on and switch it off. Everyone got the message?
Yes, low is equal to 0.
Yes. So I want to switch the LED. I want to switch the LED pin 1 on. So what I will write, Ojas?
You would write 1.
Okay. Digital write in bracket LED pin 1 and 1. Okay. Okay, so like now we know how to switch on and switch off a thing. But for example, you want to conserve electricity. You want the LED should be supplied some lesser amount of voltage and still it should be on. So here we introduce the variables. So I am again starting screen sharing. Can everyone see my screen? Hello? Very good. You both told at the same time.
Yes.
Okay. It takes some time. I think done or not done.
Fritzing beta.
I had asked you to download a software called as Fritzing. Do you remember?
No.
I don't know what is happening to this. I will just try to open it once again. Okay, so here is our breadboard. Adrut and Ojas, please take the
Yes.
breadboard on your. Please take the breadboard, and then I'm taking the board.
Have taken.
Okay,
Me too.
very good. So in the third class, and using a breadboard is very important. So just see properly how we use a breadboard. Can you see this vertical columns
Yes.
and these horizontal columns?
Yes.
For
Yes.
example, I want to connect 10 LED pins to a single pin 13, digital pin 13. How I'm going to connect that? So here comes the use of breadboard. In these vertical pins, these are 5 pins, and if I connect even to any one of these 5 pins, I can use all the 5 pins as the digital pin 13. I will be showing you how this happens. Can you see that these pins have become green?
Yes.
That is because whenever a pin is connected to any of these vertically pins, all the pins get that charge. Like, if I connected to any one of these vertical pins, I have connected digital pin 10. So I can use all these 4 remaining pins as digital pin 10. Okay?
Yes, but what about the above ones? Why are they not?
These ones.
Yes.
This is because whenever you can, these all are actually segments. This is one segment, this is one segment. Means, can you see
Oh.
this line here?
Yes, in the middle, right?
Yes,
Yes.
that divides it. So you can use, if you are connected here, you can use only these 4 remaining pins. You cannot use that pins. And however, if you want still more number of pins, you can connect, like now I'm connecting digital pin 8 here. Did you see that all the pins in this row have become green?
Yes.
I will zoom it so that it becomes easier to see that. Can you see?
Yes.
So whenever we connect to a vertical, like this column or this column, what happens is that only you can use some vertically pins. If you connect here, the remaining 4 pins, you can use them as digital pin, any digital pin. And whereas if you connect here, like I have connected here, you can use all the horizontal pins. Like if I connect this horizontal pin to any LED, that LED will have the digital pin 8. So you can use this. So we'll just take a LED as well.
Iron Dada,
Yes.
can you tell materials and Can you tell the materials which you have used to make the heart rate machine?
I can tell you the materials. However, okay, I will tell you now. Just 2 minutes. Like this is
no,
a sim.
You can share the image and program on WhatsApp.
Okay. So now I have connected digital pin 8. So all these horizontal pins will have the like they will become same as digital pin 8, and then you can connect it to any LED and use it. And now if I want the ground pin, I will connect it here. For example, here. So I can use these all pins as the ground pin. Instead of one, you will have many pins as ground pin. Isn't that interesting? You can use one pin as many pins. And for many things.
Very interesting.
Okay. So this is how a breadboard can be used. Like, just remember in the mind, the middle two columns, this and this column. This column and this column, both of these columns will have, like, if you connect to any one of these five pins, the vertically the pin will be used. Like, we have connected digital pin 13, so it can be used. Whereas, if you want still more number of pins, you can connect here horizontally. Then all the pins in that horizontal line can be used. Is it clear? Hello, Adrut.
Yes.
Adrut and Ojas.
Yes, it is clear.
Yes.
Okay. So here where we had switched on a LED, but now I want that a LED, as I told you that I want the LED's voltage should be changed according to us. So what we will do here is, Adrut and Ojas, please take your Arduino Uno board.
Yes.
And then, can you see my screen clearly?
Yes.
Okay. Here, I will connect the LED 2 to pin 11. And in Arduino Uno board, there is something called PWM, right? Did you see that?
Yes.
And it has a sign.
Yes.
The pins such as
yes,
11.
Beside digital.
Wonderful. Very good. Very good. So all the pins having the sign of PWM can be used for changing the voltage. And a new type of connection will be introduced here. Now we will be using the function called as
analog write.
Very good. Very good. Analog write. Do you know why? Adrut or Ojas, any one of you can tell why we are using analog write instead of digital write.
To reduce the volt.
That is also
to,
right.
To reduce the voltage.
Okay, that is also correct. But another thing is that whenever you are using digital write, you can write 1 for on and 0 for off. Okay, so there are only two things you can do, 1 or 0. It's fixed, on or off. But if you want that it should be slightly on and a little voltage should be supplied to the LED, buzzer or whatever you have connected, for that time we need analog write. And then we will introduce a variable. And for introducing variable, we use int. Const int means constant integer. And that integer will not change. So this is why we use const int for introducing connections. Because connections are not going to change. Right? And for...
You...
Yes. Yes, Adrut.
I am saying that...
Nothing.
You will write that now int background.
Yes. So we will write, as we are using a LED, or LED has its brightness. So let's keep the brightness as 10 or 5. Okay, 5. Then, after introducing a variable using int, we will now write LED2. We had already introduced the pin LED2 here. We will write LED2 comma brightness. So what happens here is whatever you give in the variable like 5, so 5 will be maximum and 5 will be taken as 5 volts. And if you want lesser than that, you can write a function called as if condition. I will give you a practical example for this. For example, I'm not telling that you always tell, but sometimes you may tell your mother or father that if I take good marks, please take me a new remote control car or anything. So this is where we use. First of all, we tell what should we write there. If I will write here as if brightness is lesser than 0. Okay. Adrut and Ojas, can you tell me what does brightness lesser than 0 mean?
Brightness is less than 0.
Yes. So this condition will execute on now whatever we write inside this if condition will be executed only when the brightness is lesser than 0. So we'll write as if brightness is lesser than 0, brightness will be equal to 5. We'll write another if condition. Here we will write as if brightness is greater than 0, brightness is equal to brightness minus let's keep it as 1. So any one of you, Adrut or Ojas, can tell me the meaning of this. Anyone?
Which one if brightness bigger than 0?
Both of you can try. Actually, it is a bit difficult, but you can try.
That's
Okay, I will tell. Here we have written analog write. Whenever we write analog write, as I told you, you can write any number or anything you want. Here we can write 1 or 0 in digital write. So here we wrote as if brightness is greater than 0. We want the LED's brightness should go like first it will be at its highest limit and then slowly it will reduce. So we want it to work in such a manner. And then when it is at its least level, it should again be full so that it can again reduce. So this is what I have written here. If brightness is greater than 0, brightness is equal to brightness minus 1. So simply I have written here as pi is equal to pi minus 1. Did you understand that?
Yes.
We know that the brightness value is 5. So pi is equal to pi minus 1 means the new value for brightness will be 4. Okay? And so on until the brightness is greater than 0, it will be reducing like 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and finally 0. And once it becomes 0, zero will like this condition will execute. If brightness is lesser than 0, if it is lesser than 0, brightness will again become 5, and again this condition will execute, and again from 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And there is a problem in this code. Can anyone tell what? Like Ojas or Adrut, anyone of you can tell. I had written here as brightness is equal to brightness minus 1. Can anyone tell me what is the problem in this code? Okay, I will tell. The problem here is, I have written as brightness is equal to brightness minus 1. And this will take place at it the computer speed. And the computer speed is very high. It will take less than 1 millisecond to take the brightness from 5 to 0. So this is why we have to write and slow down the computer speed by writing as delay function. Like whenever the brightness is 5, it will become 4 and it will... Like whatever we give in the delay, for example, we give as 250. If we have given as 250, it will take 250 milliseconds for the brightness to become 5 to 4, and from 4 to 3, it will again take 250 milliseconds. Is it clear? Ojas and Adrut.
Yes.
Sure.
Yes. Yes.
So we'll be seeing how this works. First of all, we will see how to switch on. We have switched on and switched off a LED, and then we have made a LED whose brightness will decrease and suddenly increase. So let's see how this happens. I am just 2 minutes. I will connect. Do all the connections. I will do all the connections and then show you. Till that, Adrut and Ojas, small homework for you that you can now just practice this and write the code. Will it be okay? We'll just send another. Okay?
Yes.
Okay. And if any doubts, please ask. And in the project you are doing now, at minimum, one LED should be switched on and off, and one LED should be faded. Okay?
Okay. Okay. We have to stop one LED and other should fade, right?
It is your wish, Adrut. However you want to do it, you can do it. It is completely your wish. But remember one thing, that one LED should switch on and switch off, and the another LED should fade. Okay?
Okay.
Yalla, pullavo, pullavo. चांगले म्यूट आहे. Adrat and Ojas, I'm really sorry that it took a bit longer time. Here is how it works. Adrat and Ojas, are you doing your project?
Yes, I am.
Okay. You can see this just for reference. One LED is switching on and switching off. However, the other LED will fade. This is the LED which will fade. Can you see that its brightness has decreased? And now it is at its highest limit.
Yes.
Yes.
Ojas or Adrut, did you do your project? Or is the code ready?
No, not now. I am doing it, not now. क्या पता है? नहीं पता, बताओ। अरे
यस, अदृत एंड ओजस। प्रीवियसली द एलईडी वॉज अगेन अगेन एंड अगेन स्विचिंग ऑन ड्यू टू विच वी कुड नॉट सी हाउ द एलईडी वॉज फेडिंग। दिस इज हाउ द एलईडी फेड्स।
ओके 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 ओके।